Because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. On first down, Brady. The throw left side complete to Hogan. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15, just shy of the 10. A gain of 32 that time.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock the defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
And they'll lose yardage here. They go backwards to the 13-yard line. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
When you're putting together a formula for winning defense, it's exactly what we're seeing in this game. Controlling the line of scrimmage, attacking, and changing everything so that now they're playing in the offense's backfield. They're playing an excellent game.
Second down, here's Brady. Dumps it off to Lewis. And here he'll get it down to the 7. Give him 6 on the play, and they're going to have a third down. Throwing is Brady on third down. And Brady going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off Byron Jones. He's at the 50. 30. 20. 10, and he will score. Touchdown, Cowboys. Third down, passing down. They throw the extra defensive back in there for a nickel package, and it worked out.
And it's not anything that you would think is just great strategy. It's just that when you have 5 defensive backs on the field and an obvious passing down, it's a lot tougher to complete a pass. And on that play, they completed it just to the wrong team, and it cost them 6 points.
An adventure thus far, but this one is good. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they throw the pick 6. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And they'll put up the stop sign there as his guys will get it at the 25. The spotlight now focuses on the quarterback, and that's Tom Brady. So with the 3 interceptions, how does he erase those from his mind and just focus on this drive?
I think he may need some help from the coaching staff. Maybe the offensive coordinator says, okay, let's do a few of the shorter throws, quick rhythm throws where the ball's out of his hand quickly into a receiver before the defense can react. Maybe not take so many shots downfield, just in case. Get your confidence back up, and then later on, you expand the targets again.
The KISS method, keep it simple, stupid, right?
I love it. I love it.
Throwing after the interception, Brady. And Gronk says, wait room. They'll tussle for it, and this is going to be caught. 23 yards on the play. Well, even after all those interceptions, he's not deterred, still confident to go deep at work there.
I think all the old rules about playing that position still apply. If things go wrong, you still act like you're the best player out on the field. You still carry that supreme arrogance with you and continue to fire the ball. I've seen guys have games like this, and this is where you find out if you're great or not. Can you overcome some interceptions and still lead your team to victory?
Throw complete right side to Cooks. And he'll get it down here to the 43. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Play action. Now Brady. Gronkowski's got it on the crossing route. And he's going to get this inside the 30. The Patriot passing game is rolling. They've got another first down. Ah, yes, Brady to Gronk. You think these two are in sync?
Without a doubt. And look, they both understand what they can do for each other. Gronk knows if he gets open, the ball's going to be there. And Tom Brady knows what a great security blanket Gronk is. When all else fails, you find big 87.
And Cooks has it over the middle. And a big collision there as he winds up flat on his back at the 21-yard line.
Well, if you want to be known as dependable to your quarterback, that's what you have to do. Go into the middle of the field, know the hit is coming, and catch the football. And that's exactly what he just got done.
And defensively, a little deflating to be able to lay that hit and not have the ball pop free, right?
No doubt about it, because your goal defensively, knock it free so that they say, okay, guess what? We're not going to throw it in there anymore. Now, they'll still continue to be aggressive.
Brady gives this one to Lewis. And they'll get him down right about the 20. Just a couple on the pickup there, and now it's third down.
There are times when I think people just overlook how good a player Sean Lee really is. One of the more athletic linebackers in the league. He can make plays against the run, against the pass, you name it. He's one of the better ones out there.
And number 50, so loved by the fans in Dallas. Brady going to try and throw on third down. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he takes it down to the 13 and picks up the first. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well.
As we well know, James White was an absolute man in the Super Bowl. But, boy, his regular season wasn't bad either. Had 60 catches.
60 catches, more than Martellus Bennett, more than Chris Hogan, something that went overlooked in his arsenal. Play fake here on first down. So tough to stop Gronk. This is caught. Gronkowski. And he's going to get into the end zone. So cue up the Gronk spike. Gets a Patriot touchdown. Rob Gronkowski from 13 yards out. And the Patriots make some inroads here on that deficit. Extra point try for Gronkowski. Oh, look at this. A flip to the kicker. He's going to try to run for it. And they'll lose yardage here. Knocked back to the 19-yard line.
Okay, they went for the fake off of the extra point attempt. It's a long way to go, and they didn't get there. Didn't get it completed successfully. Did someone dare them to do that? Did someone double dog dare him to do that? What was that?
Maybe they saw something on film, but do you see something on film when those to try something from the 15 on a PAT? I don't know.
The only thing they needed to see on film there was a snap, a hold, and someone kicking the ball through the post.
Gronkowski now out to kick it away. Now it's Lucky Whitehead on the return. And he is hit pretty hard from the side as he's knocked down right near the 27. Dak and the Cowboy offense heading back onto the field. He's played a pretty clean first half, a touchdown, no interceptions.
Frankly, that's what they expect out of him. They want to see the ball thrown and thrown well, and he's able to do that and put it in the end zone. They'd love to see more of that before this game finishes, but right now, he's got his team in a good spot.
A good spot, and maybe looking for touchdown pass number two here in the second quarter. Down throw for Prescott. Over the middle, complete. That's Butler. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. Give him nine there on the first down completion. It's a loss of two, now third down.
Let's face it, second and one, playbook's wide open, isn't it? If they can do just about anything. But after that, now you're third and three, I think the playbook has shrunk because now I think you're almost locked into throwing the football.
Third and short yardage, Prescott got his man complete over the middle. It's Butler. And he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage. If he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
He was trying to get it to Ezekiel Elliott, and that'll bring up second down.
Let's face it, perfection is something we all chase, whether it's playing this game or whatever we do. Hard to attain, but that's what they were searching for as that pass goes incomplete.
And on second and 10 now. Prescott now from the 50. Over the middle, complete. That's Butler. And he's brought down. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. To throw on first. A dump off to Elliott. Oh, Elliott gonna be hit. He coughs it up. Loose football. And the Patriots have it.
The psychology of the game never ceases to amaze me because coaches all the time, right?
And how much they practice not fumbling.
Practice it, preach it, talk about it all the time. You would think no one would ever turn it over. Yet they are humans out there running around. And we just saw another one.
Opportunistic by the defense. Now after the fumble recovery, it's Brady. And he couldn't hang on. Would have been their fourth pick of the game. Instead, second down.
Trying to decipher what's going on out there because I don't know if he's just getting bad reads. I don't know if the defense is confusing him. I don't know if he just has, you know, bad info and intel before he snaps the ball. But he's made some pretty bad decisions with the football lately.
Yeah, several bad decisions on the interceptions he's thrown in. Frankly, that should have been another pick right there.
What's tight? Tight is right. What's tight? Tight is right.
to the air on second down. It's Brady. Throw left side complete. It's Hogan. And he's brought down after a good game. A good pickup there of 20 yards. So in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver? So he's got a chance to really shatter that and have a profound effect on this game.
From midfield, here's Brady. Wiggles free. Oh, he got position on him, and he pulls it in. Give him 2 yards on that play, and that'll make this a second down.
Instead of the running back in New England, sometimes they like to call him the passing back. So they get him the ball in different ways, don't they?
They certainly do. Think about the ones they've had in recent vintage. You talk about Kevin Faulk, Danny Woodhead, Shane Vereen. James White could have been the MVP in the Super Bowl if it wasn't for a certain quarterback that was on the field that day.
Throw again. Over the middle, and it's incomplete. Gronkowski, the intended target, and it's third down.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
New England on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is 3rd and 8. Again, it's Brady. He gets it to Cooks. They showed off a nice juke of the defender before the next wave could bring him down. They get 7 there, but it brings up 4th.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say, I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. He'll go for it. It's Brady. He's got a first down and more inside the 30. And this is caught. It's pulled in by Gronkowski. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15, just shy of the 10. 30 yards on the pickup there. And it'll be first down, New England.
We know it's tough enough to pick up first downs on third down plays, but when you go for it on fourth down, sometimes you're actually just praying. And on that play, the prayer was answered.
Down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Sean Lee coming hard on the blitz. He dumps him for a loss of 8.
It's interesting, partner, that most defenses try and guard the 35-yard line actively because they think the way kickers are nowadays, about a 52-yard field goal, they're kind of giving up points. But you get even deeper into territory, you get into the red zone, they're going to guard it even more, which means more pressure, more blitzing.
Brady to throw on second down. This is complete to guess who? Gronkowski again. And he'll be that one good for 17 as they're set up better now for third down. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this.
And he is in. Touchdown, New England. Deion Lewis, a 3-yard touchdown run. And the Patriots have cut it back within a score. Solid job up front. Really just a solid job all the way around to get that one in.
That was well executed, wasn't it? Well blocked, well run. End result, 6 points.
Touchdown.
So that drive consumes 9 plays all told. And it ends with a Deion Lewis touchdown run. Gostkowski now out to kick it away. This is fielded at the goal line. Now a hit and a loose football. And it's picked up by the Patriots. And he's into the end zone. It's a fumble return and a Patriot touchdown. These two teams in this first half, it's been fun. Back and forth, back and forth. Well, it's not fun for the defensive coordinators, but offensive coordinators are enjoying it.
Yeah, they're having streaks here, aren't they? Being able to put scores together and really bunch them up, and we have a tight game here. You know, we often talk about having the right shoes for the right turf. Today is track shoes. That's what we've seen with these offenses.
Yeah, it's been an absolute track meet so far and fun to watch. So not only the cough up, but then the pickup on the other side, the scoop and the score the other way, the fumble return for a touchdown. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. And let's gaze our attention on Ezekiel Elliott. And for him, it's been pretty limited involvement. Down on the scoreboard, maybe time to turn to this guy.
And you know me well. Winning games to me means starting with the running game and continuing to press the running game. Maybe you go away from him a little bit now, but bottom line is he hasn't touched it enough to make a difference.
Well, they haven't established that running game yet. The question is, will they? The completion good for 3, and it's second down. So 2 minutes to go in a wild first half. We're back to Arlington right after this timeout. A reminder with halftime approaching, when we get there, we'll ship you off to Orlando. Larry Ridley will have first half highlights and analysis.
And I hope he's iced down his throat because he's got a lot to get through because we've had no shortage of points scored in the first.
Williams loses the football, but I believe a Cowboy was there to get it. He was, and Dallas will maintain possession. And the defense not able to get it. From a defensive perspective, what's that moment like when you realize the ball is loose?
It is a moment where all concentration goes right to the football. This is something you've talked about in all your preparation for the game. You probably talked about this training camp. Knock the ball free, take it away from the other team, and now you have that chance. It's a little bit of
And that's caught inside the 35. He got 29 yards that time. Well, we haven't been shortchanged on offense. Another fun play to watch there on the deep pass.
This game has the feel of, what, a turkey bowl, a Thanksgiving day. You know, when we get together this year, when the Davises and the Gaudens get together, that's what our playbook's going to look like they're drawing them up in the dirt. And so far, it's working for both of them.
On first and 10, Prescott. And he rifles one incomplete.
And it is true. You can draft the fastest. You can draft the most athletic guys. But if they don't know the art of positioning, sometimes it's all for naught. In this case, in the right spot, helped force the incompletion.
Yeah, but had his hands on it for a second. Would have been a tough catch, though. Falls incomplete. Prescott. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. Touchdown, Cowboys. Cole Beasley, 32 yards. And the Cowboys are in for 6.
Touchdown does not give them an insurmountable lead. It's still a lead, and that always feels good to a team.
They'd love to take that into the lockers, but a little time left on that clock, so some work to do.
I like that. I like how you're guarding against a letdown there.
Marty, looking forward.
Coaching them up from right up here in the booth.
Extra point try by Bailey. Up to 5. So that drive spanned 5 plays, and it culminates in a Dallas touchdown. now to kick this one away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And they'll put up the stop sign there as his guys will get it at the 25. And the Patriots gearing up to go now. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you've got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
Throwing on first down is Brady. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. That good for 22 and a first down. And now with that completion, he's north of 200 yards here in the first half.
And he's going to break our statistician, Marvin, isn't he? Because Marvin right now is just tallying it up. Hope his hand doesn't hurt too much doing this or keeps hitting the calculator. But my goodness, what a start he is off to. By the end of this game, he could have monster numbers. He just wants to continue to be accurate.
They go play action here on first down. And he couldn't hang on. Would have been their fourth pick of the game. Instead, second down.
While nincompoop pass certainly doesn't look like a good play, for the guy throwing it today, as many interceptions he's thrown, he's got to feel a sigh of relief that the ball actually hit the ground and didn't go in the other direction.
So the incomplete pass brings up second down. To throw again, Brady. And incomplete there, a nice hit, jars the ball free, and brings up third down.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing, and on that one, they had the fly, just sending the guy downfield with the in route accompanying it, what people call a dagger route, trying to hit the guy underneath after the clear out. In this case, though, they're not able to get it done.
Yeah, they said forget the underneath route. They went for the guy on the fly, but as you said, incomplete. On third down, Brady. This is caught. It's Cooks. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. Now the offense lining up first and 10. Again, they'll throw with Brady. Throwing left side, he's got Gronk, complete. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. This clearly the final play of the half, but no field goal attempt. They're going for it with 3 seconds remaining. Now they'll run with Lewis. And he's going to go down in the field of play. So they say no to the field goal try, and time has run out on this first half.
Thanks, Brandon. I'm Larry Ridley, and welcome to our EA Halftime.
We now proceed to the start of the second half.